Hi everyone, and welcome to Biology Professor. Today we're talking about the law of independent assortment. Now, the inheritance of biological features, which we now know are genes, follows laws that were proposed by a man named Gregor Mendel in the 1860s. Mendel worked with pea plants, and in working with pea plants, he determined three laws regarding patterns of inheritance. These are the law of segregation, the law of independent assortment, which is what we are talking about today, and the law of dominance. Now, if you are interested in learning more about the law of segregation or the law of dominance, see my other videos on those topics. But now for the law of independent assortment. It states that genes for different features segregate independently during gamete formation. So for example, when gametes are formed, this means egg cells or sperm cells in humans, traits that control different features separate into gametes independently of each other. So the inheritance of alleles for hair color, eye color, skin color, height, etc., all of these physical features, they don't affect each other. So they separate into gametes independently from each other. So for example, in Mendel's classic example with pea plants, seed color, you have alleles, alternative forms of genes. So you have an allele for the seeds being yellow or the seeds being green is the other allele. Also seed texture, there's an allele for the seeds being smooth and another allele for them being wrinkled. And these things segregate independently into gametes. So the alleles for seed color don't affect how the alleles for seed texture are inherited. Now, this law has a couple of caveats. It is true only for genes that are on different chromosomes. Of course, Mendel did not know what chromosomes were. When Mendel was working, it wasn't even known yet that DNA was the genetic material in cells. But now we know that it's true only for genes on different chromosomes because chromosomes themselves sort into different gametes during meiosis. And it's also true for genes that are far enough apart on the same chromosome to be separated during meiosis by a process called recombination. Recombination occurs when homologous chromosomes line up, and this is during prophase one of meiosis. And then they have a crossing over event. So you can see that alleles that had once been on the lower edge of this chromosome are now on the lower edge of this chromosome and vice versa. So this is what happens with recombination. You have genetic material switching from one homologous chromosome to the other. Of course, then these homologous chromosomes are split apart into sister chromatids in meiosis one. Those sister chromatids are then split apart in meiosis two. So you get gametes that will have one of these four chromosomes. And so you can see that with recombination happening 1 to 3 times per chromosome, you can get a lot of variation happening that way. And also, if we go back to talking about the law of independent assortment, if you have genes that are far enough apart on the same chromosome, they can be separated by recombination. For example, if you have a gene up here and a gene right here, well, after recombination, where are those alleles? You've got one here and the other one here. And then they will segregate into different gametes. That is stated by the law of segregation. Now, if you're interested in learning more about the law of segregation or the law of dominance, remember to see my other videos. But that's it for the Law of Independent Assortment. I hope you learned a lot, and thanks for watching.